Hola, 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 what up? Ciao, how you doing? Thank you for tuning in on the internet to Got the Fire, where we're featuring the co-founder of the United States of Indiana, who is also a local commerce advocate and a creative provocateur. Welcome, Graham.
Thank you.
Let's start by doing a toast to the ghosts.
A toast to the ghosts.
Of Central State Village.
Yeah, we're here at Central State Village. This used to be the state mental hospital, Central State Hospital. It sat vacant for
a while.
We're
in the diner? Sorry, the cafeteria.
That's correct. We're in the cafeteria. So this is where we work out of now, do all our printing here. Every now and then we open it up as a shop. So it's cool to be in a place that has history. That's kind of meaningful, much more than being in a strip mall or a commercial park.
And United States of Indiana makes products, t-shirts, cups, yada, 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 that bring people together based on?
Indiana. Based on that common theme. You know, I would love to tap into more common themes, but they're kind of hard to find these days. So I picked an easy one. Whether you're from here, you've moved here, or you've moved away from here, the shape of the state means a lot of things to a lot of people. So it's fun to tap into.
I mean, India and Indiana are just two letters apart.
Yeah,
but there are no Kolkata shirts.
Every now and then I'll get a spam phone call that thinks the company name is United States of India. So
much harder to find a United States of India than Indiana. So just saying, how do you fuel your creativity and specifically towards developing this sense of place? Like, you know, where does that energy come from for you?
I don't know. At this point, it's largely dictated by our audience. Like we despite my best effort, when I started this company, I would have wanted it to be clothing worn by punks and metalheads and the cool kids, the burnouts and the grunge kids. Unfortunately, or fortunately,
it's not a significant audience.
That's not a lot of people, and they don't have a lot of money. So now, you know, there are caramel moms and grandmas and high schoolers who buy our stuff. Some people from Bluffton for sure. So I just kind of let, you know, I think in this realm, my creativity is really dictated by the audience. Like I know what those people appreciate and what they think are meaningful products, and you kind of like let your brain run in that direction.
Yeah, so your creativity is fueled by bringing people together.
Yeah, for sure, because we kind of need that these days.
You're making people feel good by giving them wearable coolness, and you're kind of transferring that coolness of the Indiana community into a t-shirt.
Into a product, an affordable product, yeah. That is kind of the mission, I guess. And hopefully to inspire people to try to make Indiana cooler. If you look at a shirt with Indiana on it and you think that doesn't mean anything, hopefully that inspires you to be like, well, I'll make it mean something.
When it comes to business and local commerce, you're a small business. You know, I guess, what are your thoughts on the importance of small business?
Smaller is better, is in the realm of business. You know, when I played in bands, like I had aspirations to be like a big band, right? And to get famous and to tour the world. Unfortunately, as an entrepreneur, those same aspirations are problematic because when you get bigger, you introduce
bigger problems.
You do, yeah. And you introduce some systems that I think devalue the people who make the products work.
To mention the fact that let's just face it, that the United States economy is fueled by small business. We may not be represented.
Correct.
In the places that decisions are made.
You know, there's
small business.
Those...
I mean, everyone in this room is a small business.
Yeah. Yeah.
There's other people in the room.
That's an interesting juxtaposition, maybe, that the economy is fueled by small business, but our daily habits are most commonly fueled by really large businesses. You know, how strange is it that everyone in this room has the same phone? Like, this amazing technological device, and we all bought the same one? You know, like, how crazy is that?
Let's bring flip phones back.
My dad still has a flip phone, and he's very
proud of it. It's a call-specific experience, right?
Yeah.
It isn't even easy to send text messages on there, but,
yeah, right.
you know.
Right.
If you're trying to just get it done.
So it's, I try to remind people of that. You know, this amazing technological achievement that you can put a computer in your pocket and we all bought the same one. How duped were we that they got us all to buy the same one?
I mean, I love what Amex does with American Express, with, you know, local business Saturday. What is it? Something
small
like
business
that. Small
Saturday.
Business Saturday. Right. Let's make it small business Monday through Friday.
Oh, yeah. I mean, that's kind of the grand irony of our times, that Small Business Saturday was started by American Express, the people who take all of our money and charge, you know, the company that charges us a monthly fee to use our own money. It's an interesting concept.
Kind of like the conference for women that was recently run by a man.
Yeah, sure.
Like,
right.
You know, there's like, no, that's not, yeah.
Everyone's just trying to make a buck. And it's very problematic.
So, you know, you're a tangential thinker that has found a niche amongst the chaos. You know, what about the people that are passionate? You know, the people that got that idea.
I envy those people.
They want to sell pumpkin soup out of a real pumpkin.
Sure.
It's a lot of soup.
It sounds like a good idea.
But, you know, what should they do?
Do it. Just do it. Don't try to get rich off of it. There's an easy answer. The moment you become the guy who is the manager of 15 pumpkin soup franchises, you're boring as fuck, and you have a ton of employees that do not like you.
You know,
so keep it small. The only way you will be an enjoyable pumpkin soup guy is if you keep it small. Keep making it in your kitchen. The life of an entrepreneur is very predictable. You either fail, you stay small, or you get big and people despise you. Like, you know, like Steve Jobs, Jeff Bezos, think about the thousands of people who loathe those individuals because they were the boss of a system that mistreated them.
I mean, I don't find myself in the situation of agreeing with our current president, but I gotta say, Jeff Bozo is a pretty cool name.
Jeff Bozo is a pretty,
Tim Apple.
That's where we're at. The political discourse is finding funny ways to mispronounce people's names.
So, my company is a small company, and I find people saying to us on a regular basis, like, how is such a small company so highly rated, or how are you doing all these things, right?
Yeah.
So I guess the point is that people in Bakersfield are wearing United States of Indiana shirts, right? So the impact of a small business can be global.
Sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, totally. Right. You know, if you have good customers, they carry it with them.
And you care about them and you take care of them, right? How do you take care of, like, the regulars?
Send them free stuff and make sure they're happy. It's not, with t-shirts, it's not hard to make sure someone's happy. Send them another one. You know, like, it's not a hard thing to replace. Just make sure everybody's happy. We don't let any customer. I don't think we've ever lost a customer, and that's like.
Because
that's
they know that when you email them, when you reply to their complaint, that it's you, it's your company.
Yes, right. That it's the owner responding, and that means a lot.
That's sort of like removing all the layers and all the separation between you and the customer.
Yeah.
Gotcha. Let me ask you this. When you go home, like, how do you unwind?
I've been programming video games. That's my hobby. It's a completely different side of your brain than this. This is very soft skills. Like, I need to make a design that appeals to some deep-seated emotion within people. Video games programming is very, like, cut and dry. It either works or it doesn't. It either crashes or it runs.
What's your game of choice?
My video game of choice? Yeah. I play a lot of games, so I just got a Switch, the new Nintendo system. So
Mario Kart.
What's up?
So you know,
that's that.
So you turn your brain off, enjoy some video games. You should all try that. You know, let me tell you, based on our conversation today, if you got an idea for making pumpkin soup and serving it out of a pumpkin, go do a pop up, try it. Don't try to get financing. Just go do it. Right?
That's correct.
Thank you for watching. We're going to cheers you all for being awesome people.
Cheers.
Doing awesome things in Indiana. And thanks for watching. Thank you, Graham. UnitedStateOfIndiana.com. Get yourself some. Bye.